Hi, hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video we will see the simple pendulum concept with its time period in different types of cases. There are various cases that you must remember. So time period of simple pendulum is t is equal to 2 pi root of l by g, where l is the length of the simple pendulum, okay. Suppose, see that there is a lift in which the simple pendulum is hanging and it is moving upward with acceleration a. The time period is given by 2 pi root of l divided by g plus a. Suppose the lift is moving downward with acceleration, then time period is given by 2 pi root of l divided by g plus g minus a. The same thing we have learnt in the apparent weight on a lift, the same thing we are using here. If upward, g plus a, downward, g minus a. Suppose in case of horizontal acceleration, okay, suppose if it is placed in the lorry which is moving with acceleration a, then time period is given by 2 pi root of the length of the simple pendulum divided by square root of g square plus a square. So this is the, now here we have learned three cases. Now let us move on for the next case. So we have learned that time period is proportional to root l. So time period is nothing but it is proportional to l power 1 by 2. So delta t by t, that is equal to 1 by 2 delta l by l. Okay, and this thing they will ask in such a way that if the length of the simple pendulum is increased by 2%, then how the time will change, they will ask. So delta t by t is equal to 1 by 2 into 2%. Delta l by l is nothing but 2 by 100. So this way they ask. If they are asking percentage change in time, it is delta t by t into 100, that is equal to 1 by 2 into delta l divided by l into 100. This is the percentage change. And in the linear expansion, we have learned that expansion is equal to l naught alpha delta theta. Delta theta is the change in temperature. So this delta l divided by l naught is alpha into delta theta. So instead of this delta l divided by l naught, I am substituting alpha into delta theta. So alpha into delta theta, alpha is the coefficient of linear expansion, delta theta is the change in the temperature. Now for a very large pendulum, okay, very large pendulum, in the key, in how they will ask in the question means, for a pendulum having its length equal to the radius of the earth or equal to the radius, half of the radius of the earth. For such a very large pendulum, it is given by t is equal to 2 pi root of 1 divided by g into 1 by l. L is the length of the simple pendulum plus 1 by r. R is the radius of the planet. So in such a way they ask, for if l is infinity, then t is equal to 2 pi root of r by g. Okay, this is the common way they ask for a very large pendulum. That means the length of the pendulum is equal to radius of the earth. Like that they ask. For that you have to use this formula, and this is a previous year question. In a U-shaped tube, the time period is given by 2 pi root of h by g, where h is the height of the liquid in one arm. Okay, then let us see the effect of buoyancy. What is the time period in the liquid? A solid is floating in the liquid, it exhibits SHM. What is the time period they are asking? So time period is given by 2 pi root of L divided by G minus density of liquid divided by density of solid into G. So root of, it is nothing but 2 pi root of L divided by G minus density of liquid divided by density of solid into G. Now let us work out a numerical. A simple pendulum with a metallic bob have time period T. It is immersed in a non-viscous liquid whose density, so then liquid density is 1 by 4th of metal solid. So rho L divided by rho S is 1 by 4. What is the time period they are asking? So time period is 2 pi T dash. Initially it is T, that is 2 pi root of L by G. And here the time period is 2 pi root of L divided by g minus density of liquid divided by density of solid, that is 1 by 4 into g, so which is 2 pi root of L divided by 4L divided by 3G. So these two equations you have to divide and you have to find the T dash value, that you can do. So this is the formula you must remember in case of buoyancy. See, that density of liquid divided by density of solid, this term you must remember. Okay, this is the torsional pendulum. Torsional pendulum means the pendulum in which instead of the length rope or rope, we are keeping a rod or we are keeping a disc, and that disc rotates in a fixed in time interval. Then those type of pendulum we call it as the torsional pendulum. The torsional pendulum time period is given by T is equal to 2 pi root of I divided by mgd. I is the moment of inertia and m is the mass of the ring or the disc, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and this d is the, it is r for the ring, disc and cylinder, for everything it is the radius, and this d is l by 2 for the rod of length L. For a rod of length L, this D you have to take it as L by 2, because here we are considering center of mass concept. Okay, so for a rod you want to take L by 2, for other thing you have to just take the radius. Parallaxis theorem also you want to apply here for the torsional pendulum in competitive exam. It says that moment of inertia about the point is equal to moment of inertia due to the center of mass plus md square, where this d is the distance from center to the point, distance from center of that object to the point where it is attached. Now let us work out a numerical based on the torsional pendulum. See that a ring of mass m and radius r oscillate about O. So here they are using torsional pendulum. T is equal to 2 pi root of I divided by mg t. So 2 pi root of inertia, moment of inertia about O. So which is nothing but you have to use the parallaxis theorem. It states that center of mass plus md square. So center of mass is for moment of inertia for a ring is m r square plus this distance. This distance is nothing but radius. So it is also m r square divided by mg. This d is r for ring. Suppose they have given rod, you have to take d is equal to l by 2. Okay, so which is 2 pi root of 2 m r divided by mg. M and get cancelled, so it is 2 pi root of 2 r divided by g. This is the time period for this torsional pendulum. Okay, if they have given rod, instead of this I you have to take it as ml square by 3. If it is hinged at a point, then it is ml square by 3 divided by mg into l by 2. So this is the torsional pendulum concept. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, and see that this is the next thing, buoyancy effect. Already we have learned T is equal to 2 pi root of L divided by g minus density of liquid by density of solid into g. But in NCRT they have also given another one formula. T is equal to 2 pi root of density of solid into L divided by density of liquid into g. This they have given in the book back question. Okay, this formula also used, so you must remember for NEET exam. T is equal to 2 pi root of density of solid into L divided by density of liquid into g. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my YouTube channel. And this one, it is the book back question in NCERT. They have given direct formula. Okay, so that also you must remember. I hope you like this video. Thank you.